Hello? You're from the Red Hulls, aren't you? Welcome to Raiders Cove! Nothing but fellow pirates here. You and your crew don't have to kill or maim or eat anyone, right?
Kill or what? Eat people? What are you talking about?
It's what you do. Everyone knows. And it's no big deal. I'm sure those people your crew ate on Talaran had it coming. But we're all friends here, right? No need for any massacres or cannibalism here.
I might start doing one of those things if you don't give me some straight answers.
Oh, no. No. That won't be necessary. I can tell you whatever you need to know.
Someone told you I was coming. Told you all these stories about me. Who was it?
Well, word's kind of been going around, but I heard it from Goro. He told everyone that you were coming. Even knew what you looked like. He said he was gonna kill you as soon as he saw you. I'm sure he was just bluffing, though. You know?
Where can I find this Goro person?
The cantina? Probably. He hangs out there a lot. They serve good food there. No need to eat anyone.
Patogawa kiku bakili. Kusa malachikuta, ikosa mose alatuta.
You must be Goro.
Bampaula kavaji oto.
Easy, Goro. I just cleaned up after your last brawl. Don't do this to me again.
Kafstu undile, jigo hola lukuta.
Who told you that I'm the captain of the Red Hulls?
Makipuna mali tutta on Mishka.
You're gonna stop telling people these lies about me. Now.
Wonkiki atochan kampatnoka. Chisabicha.
This is the worst mess yet.
You're not gonna eat him, are you? That's the last thing I need people hearing about my place.
You're gonna tell me exactly what I wanna know. You won't use the words cannibal or pirate or any of that nonsense. Who told Goro about me? I want a name.
Kai Zaiken. He's an idiot that runs one of the crews here in town. Goro had just come from one of Zaiken's sabacc games when he started talking you up. Had to be him. I don't let Zaiken or his goons into my place. You'll have to find them out in town somewhere. And watch out for Goro's brother. He's a handful.
Kai Zaiken?
Huh? No speak basic. Ni wana wanga?
Iva chichopa halupa.
Neither did Goro, apparently. This is not my day. Hello! Yes, I am indeed Kai Zaiken. Though there are probably lots of people with that name, just saying.
I hear you've been telling people about me. Lying about me. I wanna know why.
You mean Goro? I just, you know, mentioned to him how I owed you. Just making conversation. You don't really need those credits now, do you? As in, now?
Pay your debt in information. I want to know who told you about me. Don't make me ask again.
Oh, well, if that's all you want. There was someone who tipped me off that you were coming.
Go on.
It was a message, so I saved it on my data pad. Yeah! Oh. Great! He put it in the lockbox! It's all yours! Anything else in there, too, you just help yourself.
No.
Zaiken. Greetings. I have important information for you. The Red Hulls may be the galaxy's most bloodthirsty and sadistic pirate crew, and they're heading towards Rishi. I'm sure you remember the debt that you owe the Red Hulls. Quite a few credits. Not something they're likely to forget. My droids are spreading word of their arrival. If you were to do the same, they might be too distracted to come after you. The choice is yours, of course.
Greetings, gentle being. Let me regale you with the tale of the dread Red Hulls and their monstrous, flesh-eating captain. Oh my! You are the monstrous, flesh-eating captain of the Red Hulls! What a singular pleasure to meet you!
Who programmed you to say these things about me?
I'd be happy to tell you. Very eager to meet you, after all. Big fans. You can find them at these coordinates. But do be careful. After your magnificent duel with Goro, there may be others out for revenge. Excuse me, you there! Have you heard of the dread Red Hulls and their monstrous, flesh-eating captain?
I've still got plenty of ammo. You want to make the same mistake as your brother? Be my guest.
Cougar! Unstable, brother. Daugai, Daugai. Daino to Ubu Savo. Daino to Ubu Shapu.
Hey there.
Theron? Lana? You're the ones behind all of this?
Guilty as charged. Sorry if we put you out, but we had to be cautious.
The Revanites have gone to increasingly severe lengths to hunt us down since we destroyed their operations on Rakata Prime.
We had to get you here to help us without leaving a trail. Sorry we couldn't be more direct.
Do you have any idea what I've had to deal with? This planet is a madhouse.
Oh? We've been watching your progress. I think you're selling yourself a bit short. Honestly, it's too bad you never pursued thuggery as a profession. You're taking to it quite well.
We need to go after the pirates that run things on Rishi, the Nova Blades. They butcher entire starship crews and enslave anyone on Rishi who stands up to them. And now we've learned that they're working with the Revanites.
The Nova Blades are being sent to attack trade lanes in very specific areas. They've gradually remapped quite a bit of stellar traffic. It's all very strange.
So in all your time here, you've learned that some pirates are doing some raiding. Top-notch work.
They aren't raiding for themselves, that's the point. They could be making far more credits elsewhere. This is all the Revanites doing.
We need to shake the Nova Blades down, find out what they know. Their computers could tell us everything. But a direct attack on the Blades' base now might make the Revanites suspicious. We need to hide our real motives.
So that's why you told everyone I'm a pirate. When I attack them, it will look like a fight between gangs instead of a targeted move.
Exactly. Now, before we send you for the main event, we should hit a few other Nova Blade holdings to solidify the cover story.
The Blades have a supply cache hidden nearby. Once the Red Hulls have destroyed it, word should spread quickly. We have some mutual friends who are excited to help with the task. They'll meet you in the field to settle the details.
Jakaro and C2D4?
The very same.
While you're hitting the supply cache, we'll keep spreading the word about your grudge and see if we can find any other targets. Sound good?
You two have put me through quite a bit already. This had better go smoothly.
That's the spirit.
Good luck.
Must you complain so loudly, Master? There could be ruthless pirates or hungry wildlife all around us, hearing us, smelling us.
I was sure that Theron and Lana would have gotten rid of you by now.
This is my life.
Theron and Lana said you'd have a plan.
You mean we don't have to go charging in face first this time? We're staying in the ship? Oh, thank you, Master. Thank you. Oh, yes. Please make sure it's clear that this was the work of the Red Hulls. We need to keep up appearances, after all.
Understood. Ready to move?
It's like a war zone, Commodore. We're gonna lose everything if we don't airlift what's left to the slave camp.
And we're not backing down just because some upstart crew thinks they got what it takes to break us. Buckle down, be a Nova Blade, and kill whoever's messing with us.
But Commodore Markok...
You heard him. Kill whoever's messing with you. Or try, at least.
I took down a dozen contenders to get this post. I ain't even a little bit scared of you.
Havoc to base. Objective complete.
Nice work.
I believe one more assault on the Nova Blade's holdings should be enough to solidify our pirate feud and disguise our true goal.
One of the Blades mentioned a slave camp. Do you know anything about it?
We do. You remember me saying that the Nova Blades basically run things around here? For the most part, they're pretty hands-off. But if someone stands up to them or fails to pay their fees to live here, the Blades grab them and ship them onto the slave camp.
The slaves are a substantial part of the Nova Blade's income, both through their labor in hazardous mines and as merchandise for off-world slave traders. According to our information, the slaves are kept on a remote island under heavy guard. Do you think you can manage to free them?
You're joking. A Sith who wants to free slaves. You expect me to believe that?
This is not some elaborate deception. Freeing them contributes to our goals. It's that simple.
Since we don't know the island's exact coordinates, your best bet is to stow away in one of the shipping containers the Nova Blades take out there. Once you reach the slave camp, you can catch them by surprise, break up the security, and free as many as possible.
Just another day for the hero of Havoc Squad, yes?
Chikaro, I have a pickup for you.
C2D4 here. We have your coordinates and are on our way.
Been mining Exonium for the Blades every day for 2 years. All to pay off a lousy $3,000 I owed. And I ain't the only one.
Tell your sob story to someone who cares.
Ain't going after sympathy. Just letting you know none of us got any love from Margok and his crew. Even in this place, we hear stuff. About your gang, the way you've been making life ugly for the Blades. We want to be a part of that.
You want to work for me?
Hey, we're good at a whole lot of stuff. Tell you what, get in touch with a pal of mine in Raiders Cove. Harlow Ricks. Check in with Ricks from time to time. Tell him what you want us to do, and we'll do it. Simple as that. You get nice and close to Margok. You give him one for me, all right?
I got the slaves off of the island.
We heard. Word of your raids is going around fast. Even the Revanites have heard about the Great Red Hulls.
We just intercepted this transmission from the Nova Blade's headquarters.
This is ridiculous! How am I supposed to hold up our part of the deal if you won't give us any backup when we're in trouble?
Then perhaps we should seek other allies. I'm sure there are other crews on this planet who are capable of managing their own affairs.
Hey, we've done our share. You wanted the shipping lanes raided, we raided them. You wanted stragglers picked off from the big battles, we did it.
And your clumsiness cost us our Mandalorian allies.
Torch and her crew of old fossils, we're better off without them.
And I'm beginning to think we're better off without you. Deal with your own problems, if you want to prove otherwise.
If we keep this up, Revan won't have anyone left to keep his secrets.
He's managed to do a lot. I don't think it's wise to count him out just yet.
We'll deal with Revan soon enough. For now, we should focus on the Nova Blades.
Agreed. The Nova Blades are based out of an old crashed warship, the Aggressor. You've probably seen it off in the distance. You need to hit them hard. Make it look like the goal is to completely crush them, so nobody notices when we raid their computer cores for intel.
Chikara is refueling his ship as we speak. While you approach the Aggressor, you can use your target designator to call for his assistance, just like before.
Understood. Once I'm ready to breach the Aggressor, I'll contact you.
Good luck.
Good work.
You really are insane. Coming after us here? Should have stuck with picking on tourists in the Outer Rim.
I wouldn't have had to come here if you weren't too afraid to leave this old dump.
I have more important things to do than taking on every wannabe outlaw that lands on Rishi. The Nova Blades founded Raiders Cove. We've been here long before you, and we'll still be here long after.
I can get the doors open, but it looks like the Nova Blades have their own slicers on staff, so I can't get any real data.
I'll take care of them.
Good luck.
This is my ship. Think you could just walk on in and be left alive?
I'm in. There are dozens of comm logs in here, hundreds. Sent to people all over the galaxy. Coruscant, Droman Kaas, Corellia. The names are all encoded, but breaking through that is only a matter of time. I'm gonna get started right away. Great work.
You should hurry back. Despite what we overheard earlier, the Revanites could show up at any moment to try and help their allies. Besides, I think we've earned a bit of a celebration.
Copy that. Heading home now.
See you soon. Welcome back. You've achieved more in your short time here than we ever thought possible. You should be proud.
Compliments from a Sith don't mean much. Save your breath.
If you say so.
I also said we should stop for decorations on the way. Now the party's terrible, and it's our fault as much as theirs.
Hey, slicing the Nova Blade files is slow going, but I've already found more references to this torch person that Margok and Revan were talking about. She definitely heads up a group of Mandalorians based here on Rishi. They were allied with the Revanites, but then broke ties. And not on good terms. If we can find Torch and get her talking, she might give us some good intel. Maybe even help us take the Revanites on.
These people kill for credits. They're more trouble than they're worth.
I think that's a risk worth taking, don't you? Otherwise, we're just sitting around here waiting for the computer to finish. It looks like Torch and her crew control their own island not far from here. Think you could head over and see what she has to say?
This is gonna end badly. Wait and see.
I'm sure you can handle one aging crew of Mandalorians.
Mm-hmm. Major, I understand Havoc is engaged on Rishi without official orders.
General Garza. It's complicated, sir.
I don't need an explanation. I need you to place your mission on hold and rendezvous near the spaceport. Something's come up. I'll brief you in person.
With due respect, sir, I've uncovered evidence of a conspiracy inside Republic ranks. Until that's dealt with, it might be safer for us to keep our distance from one another.
I know what you're suggesting, Major, and I don't like it. I am still your commanding officer, and I am ordering you to these coordinates. Anything else we'll need to discuss in person. The signal is encrypted, but if we talk longer, it will be tracked. Garza out. Major, perimeter report.
We're clear, sir. No enemy contact or surveillance.
Good. What's the status of Havoc Squad?
All troops equipped and combat ready.
I'm counting on that. But you haven't disappointed me yet. I apologize for interrupting your operation. I don't doubt your objectives.
You haven't been in contact for months. You can't just pull me out of a top priority mission without explaining.
I have my reasons, Major. Do you care to hear them, or is this officially a mutiny?
Talk.
Thank you. There's a story I need to tell you. It involves a Republic Special Forces team named Eclipse Squad.
Go on.
It started with the Rakdim campaign. Your victory on Corellia was tremendous, and it's why I've been out of contact. After what happened, the Supreme Commander wanted you on top priority, frontline missions only. You were too valuable and too recognizable for covert Spec Force work.
What does any of that have to do with the Eclipse Squad you mentioned?
Everything, if you'll bother to listen. Do not misunderstand. I was proud to see you and Havoc outgrow me. Still, Spec Force needed a covert team and no one could match your track record. I had to build a replacement. I tried every combination of species and technology, but couldn't hit the right formula. Not until your operation on Manon.
That operation was a secret.
I have sources, Major. I sent a salvage team after you, and we dredged up the Revanite's Rakata technology.
You've always been too eager to use experimental weapons, but Rakata cybernetics? What did you think would happen?
I thought we'd find a way to help win this war. My science team reconstructed whatever Rakata tech they could. What they couldn't, they patched with replacements from the inventor Krell's blueprints. We cybernetically augmented 6 volunteers. They were extraordinary. Eclipse Squad was an unequivocal triumph.
Until it wasn't.
There were psychological effects. The team became paranoid. We thought it could be controlled. Then a fight broke out at Fort Clamark. The fort was destroyed and 200 Republic soldiers killed. Eclipse went dark and I've been tracking them ever since.
Those volunteers trusted you. And you as good as betrayed them when you pumped them full of alien tech. Now 200 people have died? This has to stop. You have to stop.
I made a mistake. We can discuss blame in depth, or we can solve the problem. Eclipse is sick, Major. They believe they're serving the Republic. I think they're here investigating the Revanites, but they see everyone as the enemy. Havoc is still the superior unit. Together, we have to find them and stop them.
Sounds like Eclipse is only a danger inside Republic lines. Out here, they might do some good.
Not an option. What happens if Eclipse decides to visit Alderaan or Coruscant? The Eclipse Squad members haven't deactivated their comm units. We can locate them within 2 clicks that way. Once you're close, jam their comms using the nearest relay station. They'll come hunting you.
You sure that'll work?
It's how they were trained. This isn't a mission either of us wanted, Major, but it needs to be done. I'll be on your link until it's over.
Understood, sir.
Good hunting.
Eclipse Squad has been neutralized. But you know that.
Yes, Major. Thank you for cleaning up my mess. They deserved better. But so do you.
You can't walk away from this, Garza. I just killed 6 of the Republic's finest. Too many good people have died. Eclipse and everyone murdered at Fort Clamark.
You're more right than you know. I could cover up Ando Prime, Tavis's defection, but not this. Eclipse Squad killed 200 innocent people. The politicians will pounce. My Spec Force career is over.
It's time to stop hiding behind operational secrecy. You need to tell the truth about Spec Force's full record.
No one's hiding. I've shielded the Senate from the decisions they can't face. You should know that.
But you keep making the same choices and people keep paying for them. There has to be accountability.
Would you testify against me, Major?
If I had to, yes.
I see. All the testimony in the world won't right my mistakes. I'll be stripped of my uniform, likely put in a comfortable prison. But I know better than to pit myself against you. When the Senate calls, I'll open the record.
Frankly, General, you deserve a lot worse than what you'll get from the Senate.
You've never understood. Maybe that's for the best. Maybe so long as we have strong leaders, you won't have to. It's been a long flight to Rishi, and I do need to get back to Coruscant. It could be some time before we meet again.
I understand. I've got my own mission to handle here.
Then get the job done. I meant what I said before. You've outgrown me, and I am proud. It's been an honor serving with you.
General?
For the last time as your commander, dismissed.
Edge cercano. Sas calendor neki. Orgone nel culto buco. Evestop eri. Ni as idile parnat a feden senten.
Approaching Torches Island. I take it you're the one they call Torch.
Shay Vissla. That little nickname the locals came up with. Hell if I know why.
You recently had a falling out with the Revanites and the Nova Blades. I could use your help.
I bet you could. Tell you what. Instead of whatever grand gesture of cooperation you thought might happen here, why don't we try something a little different? Been a while since I had a decent challenge. I'm taking this opportunity to show my clan how it's done.
Not bad.
Not bad at all. Been a while since someone's given me a fight like that. You should be proud.
I wonder how your helmet would look if I mounted it on my wall.
Now. We've had enough fun for one day. Didn't you come here for intel on the Revanites? We were the ones who hooked them up with the Nova Blades. Even helped them win a scrap or two. Once they started the secret, manipulating all-out war nonsense, I pulled us out. I've had my fill of war.
So all those years of murdering Republic soldiers and Jedi wore you down?
No such thing as murder in a war. That's part of what makes them so boring. You spend most of your time waiting around between battles, and when they finally happen, it's just a bunch of random killing. I prefer my fights sporting, or at least interesting.
And the Revanites don't?
Nope. They stack the deck as much as they can. I do know they've got a whole fleet of warships tucked away somewhere on this planet. Never gave me any real details or coordinates, but they're here. If you want to find them and smash them up, more power to you. I liked this place a lot better before they showed up.
If we ever fight again, you won't be walking away.
Aw, I like you. Let's get you patched up, Vode. I've been going too easy on you.
We can't afford to be so reckless, Jacaro. Losing Theron is bad enough. What if we lost you too?
Now, everyone, stay calm. Queen Lena of Onderon once faced a similar predicament, and her solution was quite creative.
Shut up, droid!
What's going on? Where's Theron?
He was captured. The Novablade's data listed a Revanite safe house here in town, and when we tried to investigate... Theron is the only one the Revanites saw. They may not know about the rest of us. If so, we need to maintain that advantage.
Between the two of you, there was no hope of rescuing him. I don't buy that for a second.
That's not the point. Whether we saved him or not, the attempt would have revealed us to the enemy, and then we'd be running now instead of completing our mission.
I really think you're all much too worried. They took him alive! That's a good sign. They're probably just torturing him a bit. Maybe doing some interrogation, where... he could tell them about us. Oh, no!
That won't be an issue. Theron has several discreet implants to help him ignore pain and chemical manipulation.
What if Revan or one of his followers used the Force? Couldn't they read his mind?
I've never been able to... Yes, I've tried. I'm sure it's no surprise. Theron's mind is highly ordered, very resolute, probably due to his childhood training by the Jedi. He'll keep our secrets, and we will rescue him. But right now, we need to focus and think it all through, just like he would.
I trusted Theron. I don't trust you.
Trust that I want to defeat the Revanites just as badly as you do. Now, what did you learn from the Mandalorians?
Revan has a hidden fleet here on Rishi. He's preparing for some kind of battle.
A hidden fleet. Pirates altering shipping lanes. That's it. They aren't just affecting the shipping lanes, they're also changing Imperial and Republic patrol paths.
Revan is trying to draw them into a battle.
Here, over Rishi. With his own ships in the mix, both fleets could be devastated.
That must be his goal. Weakening both sides so that he can make his own play.
We have to find some way to interfere.
I know where to find them! After they caught Theron, I intercepted their transmissions. After that, triangulating their base was a simple calculation. I completed it almost 87 seconds ago. They're on a small island not far from here. The native Rishi have a trading village on the same island. I'm sure they'd give us comfortable lodging.
Then let's go.
We need to clean up any trail we might have left here. You go on, we'll meet you shortly.
Oh, I used to love cleaning.
Greetings. We watched you fighting on the beach. The other off-worlders were very unkind. We are much friendlier. Have you come to trade? Do you need lodgings? Outsiders are always welcome here.
My friends and I are going to be staying here a while. Do yourself a favor and stay out of our way.
If you say so. As long as you don't trouble our people, we'll be happy to leave you to your business. An entirely new off-worlder. We've never encountered your language. Please, speak more.
Oh, there's no need for that, I assure you. I can speak quite well for both of us. Allow me to introduce...
The second head speaks too. I assumed it was decorative. How fascinating.
You mentioned the other off-worlders earlier. The ones who attacked me. What do you know about them?
We don't know much. I'm afraid they usually avoid us. It seems a little rude, but we know that our ways are different. They have some camps on the island. They wear different colors, dark in one, light in the other, but they all work together, like you.
Revanites. Some from the Republic, some from the Empire.
I think you're right. I'm still going over the data Theron decoded from the Nova Blades. Go to those camps and interfere any way you can.
I don't take orders from you, Sith.
Then stay here and waste time while our enemies move against us.
All right, you're here.
You got us.
The commander of Havoc Squad. Expert at executing traitors. That's what your mission here is all about, right?
There's no mission, Captain. I'm here on my own.
Then you're even crazier than I thought. We've sworn to overthrow the governments who've kept the galaxy divided for so long. To end this war. How can you possibly justify standing in our way?
I didn't come here to have a discussion with you.
You... never...
With all of the security alerts, I was expecting more. Do us all a favor and die quickly, soldier. You've wasted enough of our time as it is.
You're back. The Rishi told us about some disturbances in the camps.
I dealt with them both. Theron is being held in another Revanite stronghold nearby. Do we know anything about it?
The Valley facility? We just learned about it ourselves. The Rishi tell us there are quite a few starships hidden in the vicinity.
Revan's fleet.
Precisely. And according to the Nova Blade's data logs, his plan is moving swiftly. Fleets from the Empire and Republic are approaching as we speak. These aren't just small patrol groups. Both navies have gathered their most powerful warships. They're being overseen directly by Darth Maar and Satil Shan.
So I might get a chance to take down the head of the Dark Council.
Exactly the sort of thinking that would let Revan outmaneuver us all.
What do we know about the Revanite facility?
It seems to be their primary operating center on Rishi. Heavy security with only one clear path of approach. You'll have to attack straight on if we're to have any hope of rescuing Theron and stopping this fleet battle.
Then that's what I'll do.
We'll assist you any way that we can. Good luck.
And in. Theron's toys make all of this slicing much simpler than I'd imagined.
Can you find any hard data on his location?
Let's see. Here we are. Recorded interrogation sessions. Coordinates are included. I'll forward them along.
What about Revan?
No information either way. I'd advise caution.
Another pointless attack.
Where's Theron?
He and I have had some interesting conversations. My own flesh and blood, completely blind to the sacrifices I've made. I've struggled for centuries to preserve the galaxy, to protect future generations from the most destructive evil that's ever existed. How can none of you see this?
What I see is a single madman getting lots of people killed.
Then you are blind to the truth as well.
You're here. Come on, we have to go. Now.
Theron?
Escaped all on your own. I hoped I would have more time to make you see.
He's got a signal jammer that's blocking all starship communications in the Risi system. The fleets will come out of hyperspace practically on top of each other. No coordination, saboteurs in every crew. It'll be a massacre.
And at last, the board will be cleared of distractions.
Self-destruct sequence. Come on, we've gotta go.
Look out!
Hello? Is everyone all right?
Lana, you shut down the self-destruct?
I'm beginning to get the hang of this slicing business.
I've created a monster.
You should hurry back. The Republic and Imperial fleets will be arriving very soon.
Understood. Moving out.
I'll meet you there. Need to grab a few things on the way out. Attacking from the air is pointless. The anti-air defenses are much too thick.
I'm afraid of them. Doesn't that count? What are our other options?
I think a surface attack is our only real shot at taking the jammer down.
Leave that to me.
Perfect. We'll arrange transportation for you.
You've got to move fast. The fleets are going to be dropping out of hyperspace any second now. The longer we take... the more we lose.
If the Imperials are the ones taking most of the damage, maybe we should let this play out.
I don't think we have any way to guarantee that. Better to face them on our own terms than Revan's. I need to finish slicing the last of these Nova Blade files. They have data on every ship with Revanite infiltrators aboard. Since the jamming clears, we'll have to broadcast everything we've got to convince the fleets to cease fire and lock up the Revanites and their crews. One last thing since Lana stepped out. Watch your back. I'm starting to think my little visit to the Revanites might have been her idea.
You think she's working for the Revanites?
No, but I don't think she's putting all her cards on the table either. Just... stay alert, all right?
Don't worry about me. I never fell for that friendly Sith act in the first place.
I didn't think I had either. Good luck out there.
I don't know if you can read me, but I've arrived.
We read you.
Thank you.
sending out the files now.
Republic Fleet, come in. Do you read me?
Flagship Dauntless here. Patching you through to the command deck.
This is Satil Shan. Do we have you to thank for shutting down that jammer?
That, and a whole lot more.
There are traitors hiding on every ship in your fleet. The Imperial ships, too. They're manipulating the battle from both sides.
I'm transmitting the traitors' names now. They're part of a cult. The Order of Revan.
Revan? But he was killed.
Apparently it didn't take.
All ships cease fire. Open a channel to the Imperial Commander.
I've been listening. As ruses go, this is quite creative.
It's the truth. Round up the people from Theron's list and see for yourself.
And if you're correct, what do you propose?
A meeting, face to face, on neutral ground.
There's a town on the surface, Raider's Cove. We'll send coordinates for the meeting spot.
Very well.
I hope you know what you're doing.
Would anyone like some refreshments? We have several fine beverages available.
No, thank you. I'm fine.
All right.
Off to a good start.
Do we have casualty reports from the fleet battle?
It was bad, but it could have been much worse.
The Revanite ships have all been scattered, captured, or destroyed. Their accomplices aboard our vessels are in chains. You found a threat and given us the means to root it out. Separately, what do we have to discuss?
Revan is still alive, my lord, and his plans don't stop here.
The Emperor's not dead. Revan thinks he can fix that, but he's wrong, isn't he?
No one person, not even Revan, can truly destroy the Emperor.
Of course you'd say he's indestructible.
I do not speak with pride or misplaced faith. I know the depths of the Emperor's true power, and the true ramifications of Revan's interference. The Emperor's current state is nebulous, incorporeal. To strike at him, Revan will first have to return him to a physical form.
Which is exactly what the Emperor wants.
He will destroy Revan, then move on to the rest of us. In time, he will consume all life in the galaxy.
You knew that was his goal and still followed him?
I only learned of his true plans recently, and I am no more interested in being fuel for his insanity than you are.
We have to stop this. Intercept Revan before he can restore the Emperor's form.
The Emperor's hideaway is a secret, even to the Dark Council.
The fourth moon of Yavin. That's where we'll find Revan. He wanted me to join him there. Never said I couldn't bring a few friends.
According to our data, he still has extensive forces at his disposal. We would stand a better chance of overcoming them together.
No matter what evidence I present, I doubt the Supreme Chancellor will agree to any kind of alliance or truce.
Neither will the Dark Council, but my ships and the soldiers aboard them are loyal to me.
I can convince my troops to maintain a truce. They've seen Revan's threat firsthand. And we meet on Yavin 4.
Agreed.
Theron.
We can talk on the way to Yavin. I have some business to finish here.
Thank you for your help. All of you. This can't have been easy.
The conspiracy is finally exposed. We've been hiding our actions from our allies for so long, it's a relief to have everything in the open.
So we can talk about how you threw me to the wolves now?
I made a calculated strategic decision, and it worked, as we can all see now.
And if you had talked to me about it, I would have volunteered, but you didn't even give me a choice.
We couldn't risk the Revanites knowing that your capture was a ploy. You had to be in the dark for the plan to work.
I don't care what your excuse is, Sith. You lied to us. Do it again, and it will be the last time.
I will do whatever serves our goal best. Defeating Revan must outweigh all other concerns. I think it's time we moved on. Yavin is a long way from here.
Agreed. Let's get moving.
I'll see you there.
Safe travels!
My master wishes to report that the surrounding terrain is quite rugged. The Revanites are based in an ancient temple nearby. We found no usable supplies or shelter.
The other scouts gave similar reports. There has been some contact with Revanite patrols, but no heavy resistance as yet.
We got a base camp, elevation, decent perimeter. Bring me up to speed on the rest.
We need better eyes on the region around us. Scouts can only patrol so far and brush this dense.
It is more than that. I sense their fear, their distrust. This world is mired in ancient hatreds, and we have brought more than our share already.
Was there a suggestion somewhere in all that?
The troops are too distracted by each other to keep a proper lookout. They're expecting to be stabbed in the back.
Then we'll set an extended perimeter past the outer guards and make it impartial. Sensor equipment doesn't pick sides.
I can take care of that.
Once our position is secure, we can focus on Revan.
If you're thinking about attacking the others while I'm gone, think again.
I'm sure we'll be fine. I'll stay in contact while you're getting those sensors up.
Good luck.
Finished planting the sensors.
Good work. Before you come back to base, I think an extra modification is in order. With a few tweaks, we can set the sensors to forward us extra data on Imperial activities, and won't even know it's happening.
You want to spy on the Empire's forces?
I think recent events have taught us to keep an eye over our shoulder. We won't be doing anything to damage their capabilities, just staying informed on them.
You don't have to convince me. Just walk me through the modifications.
All right, start with the internal communications processor. That should do it. I'll scrub our chaff on the comm lab. You should get back to base. Theron out.
Welcome.
You sense it too. Not the ancient Sith or the Emperor. Not Revan. Another presence. Different from the rest.
Yes. It is more like you.
Are you saying there's another Jedi somewhere near us?
No Jedi could survive here alone. It is a vestige at most.
You sell us a bit short, Mar. But in answer to your question, no. The presence isn't exactly that of a Jedi either. It's still very difficult to pinpoint.
Sensors are picking up something a bit more solid. Large structures, mixture of ancient and modern materials. Looks like they've been ransacked. Lots of debris.
Check for broadcasts in signal range 47.2.
What am I seeing here? It's encoded.
The facts behind a rumor. That signal range is used only by the Imperial Guard. The structure we've found must be their training facility.
Rumor? Are you telling us you never knew where the Imperial Guard came from?
The Emperor's Inner Circle guards its secrets carefully.
If the Guard has a facility here, they may have information on the Emperor's hiding place. That would lead us straight to Revan.
Agreed. As this concerns only Imperial interests, I will assemble a team of my own to investigate. Beniko, with me.
We can't sit back and watch. There's no telling what they might pull out of that facility. We can't just take their word for it.
Hurry. While Mar is gathering his team, make your way out of the camp and search the Imperial Guard base as quickly as possible.
We'll stall the imps as much as we can. Let's just hope this doesn't turn ugly.
If things get bloody, just be sure to leave some imps for me.
And let's just hope it doesn't come to that, huh?
May the Force be with you.
Invaders! Interlopers! This world is off-limits! He told us from the start, only the devoted, only the purest, his orders, his command!
Great. Someone to question and he's lost his mind.
No, I see clearly. His sight can never be lost.
You were attacked by the followers of a man named Revan. Do you know where he's gone?
To the temple! And from there, the final steps are walked. We have failed, but so will he. Plans within plans, always. This too has been foreseen. All possibilities are witnessed and adjusted for.
What are you talking about?
The end is inevitable. all will be devoured to fuel his transcendence. All nations, all worlds, all species. You, me, Revan. None will survive. Let the end begin! Be his sustenance! My death serves his will, as all do. We are the fuel. Our sacrifice ignites his blazing glory.
I see you've made a new friend.
This man is the only survivor of Revan's attack. We need to take him back to the camp for questioning.
Then we will. Return to the camp. We have much to discuss.
Closer.
I told you this was an imperial matter. Your soldiers' involvement was unwelcome.
We're supposed to be working together. If the situations were reversed, wouldn't you have done the same thing?
You don't trust us.
Betrayal is the core of your beliefs. You can't honestly find this surprising.
Is it surprise that you hear in my voice?
Kill each other now? Wait until later. It's all the same. It all fuels the flame.
Enough. I will wrench the information we need from this man. The rest can be settled later.
Interrogate him however you see fit.
I encourage you to observe. I have no need for secrets.
Allowing this torture makes us no better than Revan. We can be better than Revan after he's dealt with. I need to meditate on the path ahead. There must be a way forward without such sacrifices.
And at least a few of us had better check up on Mar and Lana.
I thought the interrogation we faced on Manon was severe. Arth Mar made that little session seem like a picnic.
Let's find out what we're up against.
A device for mass ritual sacrifice? That's seriously what he called it?
Capable of killing every living thing on this moon as fuel for the Emperor's resurrection.
And housed within the very temple the Revanites are using as their base of operations.
So, we'll have to breach the temple and shut the weapon down before Revan can activate it.
Getting inside at all will be challenging enough.
The temple entrance has a locking system that can be overridden from the outside, provided we find the right mechanisms.
On it.
I certainly never thought we'd be killed by an ancient Sith murder machine.
We didn't exactly have a choice. Everywhere we go, you follow.
Think I found the locks Ivan mentioned. You better get out there and take a look. We'll feed you info as we find it.
Good luck.
Good. You have opened the way.
Revan! How is this possible?
Through the Force, anything is possible.
When the Emperor's followers struck me down, I learned to release my attachments.
Then who's wearing your mask and leading your followers?
I do not know. But I recognize much of myself in him. The darkness I left behind. He must be stopped. His fury will only strengthen the Emperor, not destroy him.
If you know how to stop this madness, tell me.
You are on the right path. Continue. Survive. Persevere.
Way is opening.
I just spoke to Revan.
You what? He was there?
It was his spirit. He couldn't tell me who's wearing his mask, but he did confirm that trying to kill the Emperor wouldn't work.
The man who tortured me was an imposter? How could he know so much?
We can sort that out when we face him. For now, we need to focus on the weapon he has primed inside the temple.
You're right. We're only going to get one shot at this. Once our forces enter the temple, it's only a matter of time until our friend pulls the trigger.
A joint strike, committing all of our forces and the Empire's, has a good chance of pushing through the temple and disabling the weapon before it can fire.
An operation like that needs perfect coordination and trust. It might take some doing to get our troops working together at that level.
What about a small unit operation?
A small team might be able to infiltrate the temple and reach the device before it can be activated, but they'll be facing some steep odds.
You have led the mission this far. Our victory is within reach. We'll let you decide how best to achieve it. Revan's spirit.
Are we ready? All teams report ready. You've done very well. All of the soldiers here look up to you. Imperial and Republic both.
Let's proceed.
All units, move out. All units report success. The weapon has been shut down and all Revanites neutralized. Only one more left to deal with.
Ivan told us where Revan might go. The Emperor's final sanctuary.
We've got speeders prepped. You won't be facing him alone.
I'll take all the backup I can get. Let's move.
Entire armies barely managed to drive me back. You think you'll be able to face me without them?
No soldier fights alone.
Shay Vizsla?
Wouldn't miss a fight this good.
Bring as many fools as you like. You won't stop what must be done.
You don't know what you're doing. The Emperor is too powerful.
No, not any longer. I have set my will against this creature for centuries. Only I can destroy him.
But you aren't Revan.
Who else could do what I've done?
Who else would have the strength to come this far? I am Revan, and I will complete the work I started so long ago.
Your time is long past. You don't belong here. You belong in the ground.
Not until he is gone forever.
Can't you see what you've become? Your hatred and regrets are consuming you.
My own flesh and blood standing against me. The depths of his corrupting influence are endless. I will waste no more time. This must end now!
He is strong with the Force.
You are sealing the galaxy's fate.
I won't let you win, Revan.
You cannot deny me!
What's happening?
Impossible! The ritual hasn't even begun!
The deaths you've caused, the war you've fueled, it is all mine. This galaxy is mine. It's time I claimed it once more.
Sound off. Any injuries?
We're fine.
That was him.
The Emperor.
How is that possible? We stopped Revan.
He did not assume a physical form or possess a body, and he left as soon as he appeared. None of it makes sense.
Still packs a punch.
The General is entirely misinformed, Your Eminence. A few coats of paint, and I'll be ready for the Lunar Gala.
Looks like we weren't the only survivors.
It's about time we finish this. Wait.
I've failed.
As have I. So many centuries. The Emperor and his dread masters trying to wrench me apart, to unleash my anger and hatred. I detached myself from the pain, focused on the Force.
You hid behind Jedi platitudes. You weren't strong enough to survive the torture or the battle in the Foundry. I faced them. I survived them.
You've carried on, dragging the remains of a body that should have long since faded to dust. Hatred fueled cunning, but burned out all wisdom. Without me, you could not see.
And without him, you died. He needs your wisdom, but you need his strength, his focus.
Let me help you finish what we started. I am whole again. But there is much to do. The Emperor has returned. Steel yourselves against what will come.
Let's get back to base camp. He was right. We have a lot to do.
Your actions are confusing, to say the least. I don't appreciate being left in the dark.
Does the Supreme Commander share these concerns, Chancellor?
He does not, but that is hardly...
The two of us have been fighting this war for quite some time now. We know what we're doing, and we appreciate your trust in us.
Just as I'll appreciate being informed when your fleet is back in position, so rush out.
I guess ignoring the boss runs in the family.
Ignoring Suresh is always a good idea.
Never knew you were so political.
Our forces are preparing to launch.
I should make sure ours are ready to do the same.
It's strange. The next time we meet, our circumstances will be... quite different.
Well, don't take it personally, but I'm hoping that you'll never see me again.
And I'll hope that I do. I'm glad we could put aside our differences and achieve so much. It's been quite interesting.
This truce ends the moment you're gone.
If we meet again, don't expect any mercy.
A traditional Sith farewell. You're so thoughtful. Until next time.
Well, quite a ride, huh? Revan's down, the conspiracy's over. I even got my job back. Wonders never cease.
The Emperor still managed to come back. I'd call that a mixed result at best.
We did everything we possibly could have. Come on, we better go check up on the bosses.
The Imperials are leaving a small force of volunteers behind to watch for any further activity from the Revanites or the Emperor. We'll be doing the same.
As it happens, Jakarl and I have received several lucrative business offers. Various acquaintances made on Rishi, nothing to concern yourselves with. That being said, we have sincerely enjoyed our time with you and would gladly provide our services again at any time.
I honestly can't believe we put up with you as long as we did. Beat it.
How dare you? After everything we've done.
There's more for us to discuss.
Thanks to your old boss, Spec Force Division is going through some changes. We can't afford to lose Havoc Squad in that mire of bureaucracy.
A special joint task force is being assembled between the Jedi, the SIS, and the military. Destroying the Sith Emperor is the group's sole purpose.
On the recommendation of Supreme Commander Malcolm, you have been appointed to serve as the task force's primary military advisor. Congratulations.
I'll take whatever title you want, but don't expect me to sit behind a desk.
Wouldn't dream of it. Primary military advisor just sounded nicer than head bad guy killer.
We're attempting to calculate where the Emperor might have gone, but we don't know enough about his capabilities to determine anything for sure.
While we get the task force up and running, we're going to need you out there acting on your own. Follow every lead you can find.
And remember, the threat of the Empire remains. They will not hesitate to use this situation to gain an advantage over us. Until the Emperor is destroyed for good, the entire galaxy is in danger. We must be ready.